Hello, Paul Madden at the Yacht Channel. Today I'm going to do a report on a really interesting aspect of shipbuilding and operations, and that is the bow of the vessel. Yacht builders are quite careful not to show you pictures of their vessels out in seas like these, but I can assure you that any seasoned captain, whether they be on a yacht, a military vessel or commercial vessel, or sailors that have crossed oceans, have seen seas like these, and these pictures hit you right in your stomach because you know what it feels like to hit a wave, and you know what the ship's motion is. How a ship will rise off a wave and then dive off the far side of the wave just in time to catch the next one and start the roller coaster ride. And here's how Hollywood depicted a particularly bad bow entry into a wave from the Wolf of Wall Street. I covered this in my podcast with Captain Mark Elliott. And so where to begin in a discussion about bows? Because there's all kinds of chatter about the different superiority of different bow designs, the aesthetics of them, the efficiencies, the economies, and just, you know, what looks cool and what doesn't look cool. So going back to the early ships, when the front of the vessel was just the pointy end, they jazzed them up with these rather elaborate figureheads, and they have, I'm sure, lots of messages built into them, and I've been studying them a bit and trying to understand what the themes are or the messages. Don't mess with me, obviously. Some of them are quite aggressive. Predominantly, though, they are women. Some are a little mysterious. I don't know what this woman's holding in her hand. And some of the women are, you know, a little bit aggressive. They like to show some skin. I don't know if this is politically correct anymore. And here's a sort of a flying pinup motif here. And this is an interesting one. A very angry woman, and looking a little bit closer, in her left hand she's holding somebody's scalp. So this could be a message for the crew members. That could be an angry wife, and the message might be, don't mess around in foreign ports. Getting back to the subject at hand, we are going to get into the science and the engineering of bows. But before we do, one more step into the past. Lest anybody think that some of these design ideas are very radical and completely original and modern, we've got to pay homage to the French, the British, and the German dreadnoughts going back over 100 years, really. There are a number of really interesting and significant bow designs that were developed for warships. Not so much in the commercial fleet, but definitely the warships had some radical looking bows, and they were shaped that way perhaps not just to cut through the waves, but also for the purpose of ramming other vessels and sinking them. And I'll leave it to others to comment if any of the yacht owners have used that criteria in designing their bows as well. And check the bow on this American-built 257-foot yacht, the SS Delphine, that was built in 1921 in the United States for the Dodge family. And so why all this discussion about bows? When you look at yacht videos, they're always in flat seas, perfect conditions, it's sunny, it's wonderful, no champagne glasses are falling over, and no water is slopping out of the jacuzzi. But sooner or later, all vessels are going to be in some severe weather, whether intentional or not. And this is where the shape of the bow has a lot to do with how the vessel rides and the seakeeping capabilities. Also about how fast it's able to pass through the sea, because if the vessel is getting knocked straight up in the air by every wave and digging up tons and tons of water across the foredeck, it's not operating in its optimal capacity. This is aside from safety factors and safety considerations, and also the comfort of the crew. When a vessel is pitching like this, there's going to be a lot of people puking. Let's be honest about it. This is very uncomfortable. So anything that can make the vessel go through the water with less pitch and less abrupt slamming in and out of the waves, and giant waves going across the deck and smashing the tenders and going through the windows of the boat. And this is why you see naval designers, architects, and builders in the commercial and the military sector in particular innovating as fast as they can and building new fleets of vessels with better bows and radically different bows.
The two biggest players in the bow wars, if you want to call it that, are Ulstein in Norway, who have developed, patented, and built over 100 X-bow ships in the last 10 to 15 years. And in the Netherlands, the Damen Shipbuilding Group has developed and patented a bow that they call the Seax, which again is a very unique and well-tested bow. And both companies make very convincing cases about why their particular bow is superior. In one video, you can see this Axe Bow offshore supply vessel eating the lunch of another offshore supply vessel with a traditional flared bow. Of course, without knowing the horsepower and the load factor on each of the vessels, it's hard to make a direct comparison. And maybe the slower boat just had to throttle back because they were getting beat up by the waves. So the argument is that the X bow has sharper angles at the bow. It splits the wave and distributes the forces in a more even way, and also further back from the bow into more towards the center of gravity for the vessel. And I like the fact that Ulstein refers to the orca as part of the inspiration for this bow. The orcas can weigh up to 6 tons and reach 32 feet long. And they also achieve a speed of 35 knots, which is quite phenomenal. And here's a side-by-side comparison and a tank test. You can see the vessel on the left is throwing a larger bow wave. That's gonna be more sort of smashing, more pitching, and it's gonna slow the boat down because it takes energy to throw that wave out of the way. Here's the very cool tank test for the Damen. 40 knots, 2 meter waves. And you can see that this hull is slicing through the waves very nicely. You'll also notice that it's a pretty narrow hull. And so that seems to be a defining feature of the Damen hulls, is that they are a narrow beam. They're fast, so they don't have a ton of volume, but you can make up for that by getting a longer one. And they are very cool looking. Much sexier than the axe bows, I would say. Having grown up racing on sailboats like these, sitting on the windward rail and basically getting, not that bad, but getting knocked down by every wave. I mean, every wave that you see, you feel it, and it's gonna come on board, and you're gonna get hit by it. So, I'm acutely aware of the pitch and the motion of boats going through heavy weather and getting slammed. So anything that can make that experience a little less jarring, I'm all for it. And on these larger vessels, to be able to cut through a wave rather than slam into it and rise up and then go crashing down the other side, that's all got to be good. All of these, I think, are really positive innovations. And I think that anybody that's going to build a yacht should be looking at these different alternatives and studying them seriously. I think that they're between the Axe Bow and the Sea Axe, I think that they're pluses, mostly pluses, but some pluses are greater for one and greater for the other. I think in terms of a big volume vessel, that this is the way to go, probably vessels over 70 meters. Whereas smaller vessels that want to go faster, I would think that the CX is the way to go. But again, you're going to have less volume and you're going to have less stability on a hull that is that narrow. So you're going to have stabilizers. And if you get into stabilizers, that's also cutting down the efficiency. So it's an interesting topic to study, and there's a lot more to learn, but check it out. There's a lot of stuff on YouTube. There's some very interesting videos that you can find if you scratch around a little bit. Please subscribe to our channel if you like these little reports, and I look forward to seeing you here again soon on another topic.